kachiri or cassava crisps. Delicious.
Cassava crisps or cassava chips or kachiri in Kiswahili. Really delicious. You know, my buddy is the one who told me he requested that I make this for him. But he told me that I should control myself this time round. I shouldn't eat all of them. I was like, I'm human. I can control myself. Oh, Lord, that's so good. You know, that was kind of rude of him to insinuate that I'm capable of eating like all of this. I mean, it was really insulting. I practiced self-control all day long. Oh, Lord.
Hello everyone, welcome to my Kopibo's therapy.
Recently I've been making recipes that are so simple for you to follow. And for this cassava crisps, or kachiri in Kiswahili, you're going to need the following. A cassava, of course, and some salt. But if you're a chili aficionado, you can use chili. Now for the cut, you're going to need a mandolin. But you have to be really careful with this blade. You see this blade right here? Playing around with it, it's kind of like fooling around with Jody Arias. You know it'll be fun at first, but then it'll end up terribly for you. So the first thing we're going to do is play doctor. Now let me operate on this cassava. Now with my scalpel, I'm first going to make this cut like that. Really easy by the way to peel a cassava. Simply do that. Now from this cut, you simply do this. See that? Shove it in the cut and separate it like that. Okay, once you've separated the skin, you see that how it's coming out? It's not hard. Let's perform this surgery on this cassava. See how it's peeling? It's really easy to torture a cassava, right? Yeah. Like that. And then you can set this skin up like a prized possession, you know. Now you see that the skin has come out completely. Now we simply cut it into a manageable piece and grab your mandolin and you simply shave it like that. See, it's really easy to work with a mandolin, but you have to be really careful. See this? Nice cassava chips or crisps. Can you see that? By the trick with the mandolin, if you want to be really careful, use a cloth or something, or the guard. Otherwise, this thing has sorted my fingers out a couple of times. Trust me. See that? Now I won't go past there, cause you don't want to have any casualties. Now the next thing, into medium heat oil. Medium heat. Throw in some of your cassava chips or cassava crisps. Make sure you separate them. Like that. And you wait for them to get crispy. It's that simple. Okay, once they get nice and crispy like this, you know, not burnt, just nice and golden brown, they are ready. See that? Very crispy. This will be like a medium heat, maybe 2-3 minutes in. You know, they're really thin, so cooking through is easy. Make sure you've drained all the oil from them. And then off with the gas. Like that. And at this stage, you can now salt them. See that? I'm doing it at the same time, I'm a multitasker. See how nice and crispy those are? Now. Yeah. In fact, let me serve them on this scale. Sorry about the plate. Nothing I can do about that. Guys, you have to go try making this at home. They're really delicious and healthier than potato crisps. So, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next vlog. Later. Cassava crisps. Oh, cassava chips. Oh.